Hello everyone, my name is Connor Hoffman and we are here once again doing another How to Build, this time on Axonn, the Pensive Paladin. This is a revamp of the original set, not quite an original creation, but there's enough of it in it that's original. I believe I've changed pretty much everything besides the head. Yeah, so I'm going to be doing a full tutorial. I won't be showing you how to take the original set and transform it or anything. How to Build Lamero was posted last time, so feel free to go check that one out. But for now, this is how to build Axonn, and we will start with the legs. Alright, so starting off the legs, these are the parts you'll need. As usual, feel free to pause the video, gather everything you see here, and build the little pieces I've shown you how to build, just by laying them out like this. We're gonna start by building the foot, which is by far the most complex foot design I've ever shown you how to build on this series. So we're gonna start by taking these two foot pieces, or these two chunks here, and combining them like so. And then taking this other hand connector and attaching that to the other side, like so. Alright, and then we're gonna go ahead and take these pieces and combine them like so. So we're going to want to take this and snap that to the inside on these top holes, just like that. And we're going to take this double pin piece, the double pin piece, snap that in there, and then go ahead and take this other half, or this other half size lift arm, and snap it on the other side, just like that. Then go ahead and take this construction here and do a similar thing where you take it and put it on the bottom half, like so, and then cap it off on the other end, of course. This can be a little difficult because these double pin pieces like to be pretty stubborn. Okay, so you get something like that. Next, we're going to move on to this part. Go ahead and set that down and attach this thing by putting the three-long pin all the way down and then snapping that to the inside of this Nuva armor, this Nuva chest plate, like this. Then we're gonna go ahead and real quickly just undo this part so we can snap that piece right in there. So that empty gap there will now be filled by that new piece, like so. And go ahead and snap the other side of that lift arm back on till you get that. Alrighty, now we can go ahead and attach the Metru foot, which just attaches right to that center hole through that bottom pin, like so. And then go ahead and take these two black Bowrock eyes and stick them on the open axles in the back, just like that. Next, we're going to attach this armor here, so take these two slicer foot pieces and build those constructions. On these half pin, half axles, stick the top of the construction and let them snap to the double pin thing on the bottom, just like so. Alrighty. Actually, real quick, open that back up and take these two three-long pins with the double washers on them and just set them in the holes there. This is to fill in the gaps. Like that, and go ahead and snap the other side back on, just like so. Then last but not least for the foot, go ahead and take these two chi slopes and cover up those open pins with the silver chi slopes. And that's that ridiculously large and complicated foot done. Next, we're going to do the lower legs, which thankfully aren't that complicated. So let's start by taking this other double pin piece and taking a chi slope on a half pin, half stud, and sticking that on just like that. Then taking a Nika armor piece, a Nika shoulder armor piece, and just snap that over it, just like so. And then go ahead and take this Vaki leg piece and these two constructions, snap them together like that, and then fill on the inside of the Vaki piece like that. Also, I have a little half-size tire over there to fill in that thin little ankle piece. Then last but not least, snap the whole Nika armor over the front of the Vaki leg, and that's that. Lastly, for the upper leg, go ahead and start by taking this new 2015 or 2016 actually Uniter armor piece and these other new Technic construction pieces, and on the inside simply just stick that in the lower hole facing upwards like so. Straighten it out a little. This part's pretty complex, so try and stay with me. If I can stay with myself. Yes. Go ahead and gather up these pieces here. So these two half-lift arms. You'll need this, and you'll need these two axle pieces. So go ahead and start by taking this piece and these two pieces and balancing them on the inside like so. So line them up like this, like that, so you have the axle hole lined up with this round hole in the Uniter piece, as well as the two round holes of the lift arms. Then go ahead and take this three-long axle with the stud on the end and stick it through the round hole on this side, and then stick it all the way through to hold those in. Then next, hold on one sec, this actually needs to be facing downwards with the pin on the bottom. There we go. Then take this other piece, hold it in between the two axle hole slots on the Uniter piece, and stick a three-long axle through. Just like that. So you should get all this loose floppy stuff hanging in there, like that. Next, we're going to take this four-long axle and this hand connector with the straight connector on the end and drop that through the center where that round connector was, so it lines up with the hole just like that. Then go ahead and take this Mata neck piece with the half-pin, half-axle on it and slide that over that, then set that down for a second. Take the other hand connector that with the upwards-facing connection, put a double-size or a full-size tire, I should say, over that, and then attach that again to the other end of that four-long axle. Next, take this other half-pin, half-axle and stick that in the available slot right above the other one. And I typically try and make them face the same way, just for consistency. Alright, and then last but not least, all we need to do is stabilize this so it's not so spinny. So let's start by taking this piece with the Borak eye on it, the two very useful pieces, and two washers all on a four-long axle. Line that up with the top hole, with the top hand connector like so, and hold that there while you take this chunk here, and that two right angle pieces basically, and then line that up with the holes here and simply just connect it all down like that. That stabilized one half of it. Next you'll take this piece, which is simply a construction made of two half lift arm pieces and a very useful piece, as well as some axles and a half pin half axle, so you get that. Then simply line that up right there, connect it like so. Then last but not least, to armor it, we'll take this Metru armor piece, cover up that Technic construction right there, then on the front take the red Viscerac foot piece, put it on the two exposed half pin half axles, go ahead and cap off that stud pin or stud axle with a chi slope, and then attach on the two available pins the last Vaki, the silver Vaki foot, or Viscerac foot. I don't know if I said Vaki the last time, but I meant Viscerac. And that just snaps over the whole thing like that, and that is the upper leg. Alright, now finally snap it all together, so knee joint goes right there, and then leg joint goes in the front hand connector, like so. Last but not least, we'll need the piston for stability, so this is a black 8-long axle with a stopper on the end. Put a ball joint over that, and then a piston piece that snaps into the ball joint snaps into the other hand connector on the foot, and then simply put the piston slides to the top and snaps to the inside of the that right angle piece right there. And that is how you build Axonn's legs. Obviously you'll need two, and they are perfectly mirrored. So go ahead and do that, and next we will move on to the arms. Alright, now for the arms, these are the parts you'll need. To start with, we'll do the hand, because it's arguably the most important part of the mock to get right, as it basically makes Axonn proportional. Go ahead and start with this hand connector. Then we're going to take this three-long axle with a stud on the end and this new connector piece. Slide the connector piece all the way down the axle, and as well as that, you'll take this very useful piece, put that over it to hold it together, and then simply put the two into the available hole. Then attach another very useful piece facing the same way, so it's facing 90 degrees to the hand connector, like so. And then go ahead and take a four-long lightsaber rod piece. This is an average official, like hard plastic Lego one that comes on a lot of Star Wars sets and stuff. Go ahead and attach that into a very useful piece like so. And then go ahead and take the Hordika neck piece, and as well as that, I'm going to real quick just flip this around because I've got this backwards. Shouldn't really matter except for this part being on the other side, so this is technically mirrored, however it is the exact same design. So go ahead and attach this Hordika neck piece in through there and slide the lightsaber rod all the way through. It can be a little difficult. Don't hurt yourself. There we go. And go ahead and attach two other Hordika necks on either side. There we go. Yeah, those things are sticky. And that's how you do the fingers. As you can see, they're each pretty much poseable. Then for the thumb, you'll take this black T pneumatic T piece. Go ahead and attach that to the inside of the hand connector like so, and then simply put another Hordika neck piece over it. Then for filler, add this slicer foot piece over the hand connector, and you've got the compacted Axonn hand design, which is a very similar look to the original, but is actually much more proportional, even though it's still huge. Alright, now for the lower leg, or the lower arm, I mean, which is actually pretty simple. Go ahead and take a Vaki lower leg piece, attach a cheese slope on a 1.5 pin right there, or a half pin, half stud pin, whatever they're called. Then go ahead and take this T-shaped lift arm piece, put two stud pins in the two middle holes like that, and leave the last one empty. And then two long pins on the outsides, and just simply put that over the whole thing. Then take the new 2015 add-on piece and stick that onto the stud pins, like so. That's the lower leg, or lower arm, sorry. For the upper arm, start by taking this new scrawl armor piece. Take a hand connector and put it on the inside like so. And then take a four-long axle with a stud on the, or a stopper on the end. Slide it all the way through and to hold the hand connector in, and go ahead and set that down. We're going to need the other one and a Metro armor plate. Slide that all the way through and then take a very useful piece. Push that onto the inside of the armor like so till it's all together. Then take this crank shaft piece and in the middle hole, or in the middle axle hole, slide that all the way through so you get that. And then go ahead and take this piece, and so that the pin is on the top half of the Hordika armor, or the Hordika foot piece, slide that all the way through, just like so, and take a hand connector and stick that onto the open axle. And last but not least, we're going to take this construction and just slide that over the other end, like so. And then for a little bit of filler, we're going to take a couple 1/3 plates and a 1/3 plate with a handlebar on the end, and go ahead and attach that to the side of the hand connector like I usually show you do, or like you usually do with the Gringat hand designs and such, till you get that. And then that's how you build the shoulder and the upper arm. Go ahead and take the other pieces and snap them all together. This piece likes to come undone, so be careful. And that is how you build Axonn's arms. And I managed to snap it together the exact same way. I always manage to do that. Well, just know you have to mirror one. Alright, moving on, we will start with the torso. Alright, now for the torso, these are the parts you'll need. We'll go ahead and start with the waist construction. So go ahead and take this Vaki waist, put a 1.5 long pin in the center hole, as well as taking this Technic connector and adding it to the center. Go ahead and attach this Technic connector to the bottom hole using this 3 long pin so that it sticks out, one from the front. Then take two of these other new pieces, these shorter pin conversion pieces, and stick them into the left and right holes on the same side as the other Technic connector. And go ahead and set that down. We're going to take two of these Technic connectors with the blue pins, and then one of these angled Technic connectors with a 3 long pin going through and a blue pin on the bottom. And go ahead and attach these so the blue pins all face the same direction, like so. Just like that. And then go ahead and attach that using the blue pins to the 3 connections on the waist we just constructed. So just like that. You should get something like that. That was all mostly for filler and stability. Go ahead and take this 5 angled Technic connector, and along with this slicer foot piece and the Technic connector connected to that, snap that to the 1.5 long pin in the center, and then take this angle connector and stick that onto the exposed pin, just like that. And then go ahead and set that down. We're going to need this 3 long lift arm piece with a chi slope on a stud pin. Go ahead and take two Mari cables and stick the ends in both sides of the lift arm. Just like that. Then go ahead and lining up the lift arm right about there on the torso. Go ahead and pull the cable through and attach it on either side to the angled Technic connector. Just like that. And then pull it as tight as possible without pulling out the Mari cables. Like so. It'll be pulled out a little, ideally, but that's how it should look. Okay, anyway, we'll move on. Set that down. Go ahead and start taking this Paraka torso piece, which it actually does contain the whole thing as well. Take this take this special Technic connector and attach a 2 long pin and 2 very useful pieces onto the front of it, as well as a 3 long pin onto the back. And then go ahead and stick that, I believe it goes right here, like so. On second thought, go ahead and take this 5 long axle with the 2 very useful pieces on it, and a 4 long axle with a stopper on the end, and this construction using the slicer foot piece. Put the 4 long axle going all the way through the top hole, and then go ahead and run that through the 2 very useful pieces on the other construction until you get this. And that should be pulled all the way through. No looseness here. Then go ahead and slide the 5 long axle through the center hole of the, or the top hole of the armor, or the Paraka torso. Then take this hand connector with 2 dark red Borak eyes on either side, slide that on the upper axle, just like so, and then take this double lift arm piece, or construction, with the 1.5 pin, half axle, slide that down the rest of it, and connect it all just like that. And then go ahead and cap off the top axle with a washer, and push it through on the front again if it has come loose a little. Next, you're going to combine the two pieces. So take the waist and line it up with the notch in the Paraka armors, like that, and connect it like so. Then, while that's connected, you're going to want to set that down. Take a scroll armor piece, add this technic connector to the top, and then slide a 5-long axle with a stopper on the end through it. Then, take it back, and you're going to want to take the two Mari cables and run them inside the torso through the gap behind the piston in the Paraka torso. So do that first before you do this next step. And it'll be a little loose for now, but it should fix itself once we put the next armor piece on. So go ahead and take this whole thing and sliding this axle through this hole right here, everything should line up. And you will get that. There we go. And get this. Very nice. Go ahead and cap off that last bit of axle there with a hand or with a Boracay. Then go ahead and peel these back a little bit and sort of store them for now. Now we need to add on to the bulk of the torso, so go ahead and start with these two Glatorian fists with the various greebles on them, and this is a 4-long axle with a stopper on the end through a ball joint. Go ahead and attach those by going through there, the bottom hole on the outside of the armor, and splay them out a little bit just to hold them for now. And then on the front, we're going to take two regular hand connectors, slide them down the axle, and line them up with the top of the other hole, like so. Then we're going to go ahead and take this, like with the normal Axonn construction, take this flex tube piece, and using the two connectors, slide them on over there. And then on the front, let's go ahead and bring these over and start by attaching this Nuva chest armor piece. And then last but not least, attach the two other Nuva armor pieces, the shoulder pads, like so. That will hold all that together. Then on the back, you're gonna flip this connector back down, then take this construction using a Metru chest plate piece and attach this to the blue pin right here, like so. And that should just lay down right over the back, and it actually snaps into place fairly well. Then go ahead and lay these two Glatorian fist pieces down so that the greeble lays up against that nice and smooth. Then go ahead and bring back the two Mari cables and plug them into the Glatorian fist, preferably without knocking them out of place like I just did. Very nice. And then, last but not least, take these two hand connectors with the Borak eyes and the ball joints, and on this open axle right here, go ahead and attach the ball joint so that the Borak eye faces down. And then simply just lay these up against the side of the Nuva chest plate. And that is how you build Axonn's torso. A very, very compact design. And I'll go ahead and show you how to build his head. It's basic, just the basic Metru head design with the Axonn mask. Goes on the front and snaps on the ball joint. Alright, and also I'll show you how to connect his limbs, because we have those built. Go ahead and snap the arms onto the shoulders. Like so, and the hips onto the leg joints. And that is how you build Axonn the character. Now, What would Axonn be without his namesake, his giant axe? So next I'll show you how to build that. Alright, and last but not least, this is how you build the axe. Obviously this is really similar to how the original set's axe was built, but I'll go ahead and show you anyway. So to start for the axe head, you just take this Panrak Rakshi staff piece, put 2 3 long pins on either side, and go ahead and take the 2 giant axe blade pieces, and then on the bottom 2 holes, just simply attach them and, you know, flip them accordingly so that they all occupy the same spot, theoretically. And that's the head. Now for the actual staff part, I've added some tubes to this as well as more color. This is an 8 long axle piece. Go ahead and attach a red red mata neck piece onto the top and a silver one onto the bottom. And this is a 6 long axle piece. Connect that to the bottom as well as the other red mata neck piece and the other Panrak staff piece. I also filled in all the empty spaces in the axles with Mari cable or corrugated tubes as well as washers, just to give it a thicker handle look. And then obviously the head of the axe goes on the end. Now to attach the axe to the hand of the mock, that's what the little flippy pin connectors there were for. So that very simply just attaches to the hole in the center, as well as any of the other holes on the staff as well for different poses. And then just wrap the fingers around. Typically you want to leave it so it's laying there and the thumb actually kind of holds it in place like so. And then the fingers just wrapped around it. And that is how you build Axonn and his axe. All right guys, that is it. That is how you build Axonn, or my revamp of Axonn. If you like the video, feel free to like, share, comment, do whatever you feel is right. For the awesome people section, we will go ahead and just say, if you use this entire design from Axonn, feel free to link whatever you use it with in the description, or in the comment section below, and I will feature you in the awesome people section down in the comments, which is where it will be from now on. If you'd like to use any of the designs from this mock, feel free to do so with or without credit, I do not care. Feel free to even copy the entire mock for use in any situations where you need to animate with Axonn or take pictures with Axonn, I don't care. Feel free to do so, you have my complete permission. For our next how to build, the subject will be of your choosing. Feel free to vote for any of the mocks I've made that haven't had how to builds made for them yet in the comments below, and whoever has the most votes by the next time I do a how to build will be the one I do the how to build on. Also, if you casted a vote last time, feel free to cast a vote for another character or for the same character again, it doesn't matter. Both votes on either video will count. But without further ado guys, that is it. Once again, leave your support, and I will see you in the next how to build.